Bentley. She was born in France, and her biggest lesson was to always remember, be proud of the Jewish religion. The most important lesson I've learned is to keep going. Have a love for life. They deported many of my family members, and it is important to me because I am the last generation of Holocaust survivors, and I have had a very good life.
And you are living witnesses to this time. You are living witnesses to the horrors we experienced and also the idea of being literally a survivor. At some point, there will be no more first-hand accounts of what took place during the Holocaust. And the young people that you see standing around this room today are receiving the torch of those stories that you're passing on to them. How many of you have a number imprinted on your arm? There are people here who have a number imprinted on your arm. Today, what I'd like to ask you to do, students, keep your hands up, is to come look at these numbers. Because these gentlemen and women are not just numbers, they're stories. Thank you very much, Maurice. They're stories. They are human beings, and nobody is relegated to a number, even though it is placed on their body. In our tradition, there's a phrase, Nishmat Adam Neal Adonai, that the soul of man is the light of the Lord. And indeed, these people shine so brightly today. I have one question I'd like you to answer. And that is, what do you want these students to remember about your experience? We want to give these students something to take with them. Gary just told me an amazing story, and Miss Glantz just told me an amazing story about their lives. And those stories are with me now. Tony Rios knows better than anyone that each and every person who tells her story becomes part of her very life, and then she has to pass it on. I want our teenagers to listen very carefully to our friends here.
My name is Gary Lindner. I'm from Berlin, Germany. And what I would like all of you young people to remember is it isn't just the Holocaust that we survived. There was things that happened that will never be replaced. I lost my entire childhood and youth at your age. Your age, instead of having fun, I was hiding, ducking the police for a year, and when I got caught, I wound up 2.5 years in three different concentration camps. And it took my escaping and giving myself up to General George S. Patton, the United States Army. Oh,
wow. Gary, I think you raised a really important lesson for our teenagers, not only to remember, but to be appreciative of the life that they have
Absolutely.
In this country.
Exactly. Not comparable to what we have.
It is something very special to be born in this country and given the freedoms we're given.
My name is Clara Stern, and I'm from Czechoslovakia. I was very impressed with the young people. I think they're wonderful, and stay that way, and be strong. And if somebody you hear somebody saying, it never happened, kick them anywhere you want to.
I am from Poland, and the southern part of Poland, close to Austria and Germany.
And what is it you want these students to remember?
I want you to know that I was born in Oświęcim, which is the Polish name for Auschwitz. But this was before it became so infamous.
So what you're saying is that life was created in Auschwitz, and life was also taken in Auschwitz.
Yeah,
Miriam, you're here to attest to that. That's something for each of us to take with us.
I also would like to say that we are stronger than we think. We should never give up, because as long as we are alive, we are able to improve ourselves and also improve the world.
Yeah. Thank you very much. What do you want them to remember in a paragraph?
I want you to remember one thing, to be alert. Be alert at all times. If anything happens, don't stay away. And if you have to fight, fight.
Thank you. My dancing partner of 102 years old. What's your name and where you're from?
Margie Green from Austria. I survived. I left Austria the 17th February 1934 and went to Palestine. But I lost all my people, about 30 of them.
Thank you so much. Can you imagine losing 30 members of your family, your brothers and your sisters? This young woman here, she doesn't have to imagine it. She lived it. She lived it.
Hi, everybody. And my name is Piri Feinhandler. I also was in concentration camp. And here's my friend that we were in the same Auschwitz. We spent our whole summer there. And believe me, it wasn't easy. But you have to. You really have to go on with life. Whatever life gives you, you have to go on. And here we are. And I lost a lot of, I am the only survivor from 10 of my family. And that is very, very difficult to live with. So don't take life easy. It's very special. You have to remember that and be strong and just go on and make life better, whatever you can do. It's so nice to see you here in the temple. Such beautiful young ladies and men. And so just keep going on. Thank you very much.
Last one.
What I want to tell these young people is that yesterday, while I was holding my newborn third great-grandchild, I was only thinking of those poor children that were killed only because they were Jews. 1.5 million. So all these young people, you are going to be having children that will replace those poor souls that were never able to live on their life. So that's what I want you to know.
That's beautiful. Thank you. I want to say to these teenagers, they should have lots and lots of Jewish babies. But wait till you're married.
Anyway, my name is Lucy Falk, and I was born in Antwerp, Belgium. I escaped, my father, the family escaped when we were living in France, in Menton, which is southern part of France. And in order to come to this country, my father had to show that we could support ourselves. It wasn't trying to come here and having welfare take care of us. But the thing that I want to keep saying to all the young people now is, if you find there's something wrong with your government, whether it be state, county, federal, speak up, fight for your rights, because otherwise you are going to lose them. Don't be passive. Stand up there and fight for your rights.
Wow.
I didn't know there was someone else from Belgium.
Yeah,
she's Flemish, I'm French.
Me too.
Well, there were 55,000 Jews in Belgium, and half of them were killed. The 4,000 were children. And half of them survived. I was one of them. And I survived because of a total stranger who took me in and hid me. So sometimes there is evil, but among evil there is good.
Thank you so much.
My name is Leon Max. I'm from Czechoslovakia. I lost 6 brothers and 1 sister and parents. I want you to remember, not to forget.
Mm-hmm. Harriet Saltz.
And I am from Poland, Krakow. And I was saved by Oskar Schindler. I was on Schindler's list.
You were on Schindler's list.
Yes, yes.
And your message is to remember the righteous Gentiles as well.
who helped so many people.
Not too many, but Schindler was the one who saved 1,100 Jews. If not for him, I wouldn't be alive, because I was very young.
Thank you so much.
I'm Simone Bentley, I'm from France, and France was supposed to be the country of enlightenment and welcome, and it wasn't. And I'd like to tell the young people to always remember, be our witnesses, and to keep going with your beautiful lives, and also to be proud to be Jewish.
I feel that I need to thank you, all you people who honored us to serve us in this day, and I hope you keep up that good tradition. But please keep up the Jewish tradition. It is very important. You don't have to be religious. You have to say, I'm a Jew. And I keep after my parents, my grandparents, that if I know that my grandchildren will do that, I be peaceful. And I also want to ask you one important thing. Please, wherever you do, wherever you go, try to defend the people's right of every creed, every religion.
Thank you so much.
I have often wondered why it was that I survived and endured, and so many people did not. And I don't have an answer. I shall never get an answer. I still remember my family, and it is a great sorrow to me that I did not grow up with them alive. I was younger than you when they were taken from me. But in life, if you live, and if you endure, and if you go on, you have a chance not only to live and to make a family, which we did, my husband and I, you have a chance to create good people who are going to come after and have compassion for other people, listen to other people from different traditions and different backgrounds, and respect those differences. Only that way can we hope to prevent another Holocaust.